So that the man that is tender among you and very delicate, his eye shall be evil toward his brother, and toward the wife of his bosom, and toward the remnant of his children which he shall leave. Deuteronomy 28:54 is part of a broader section in the book of Deuteronomy that details blessings for obedience and curses for disobedience to God's commandments, specifically aimed at the nation of Israel. This verse falls under the curses section and describes the severe societal and relational breakdowns that will occur if Israel turns away from God. Breaking down the verse line by line can help us understand its components and implications. The man that is tender among you and very delicate, his eye shall be evil toward his brother. His eye shall be evil toward his brother. The term evil eye is a biblical idiom for jealousy, greed, or hostility. In this context, it signifies a profound change in interpersonal relationships within the community. The phrase suggests that the previously gentle and kind individuals will become hostile and unsympathetic towards their fellow Israelites. This represents a breakdown of brotherly love and communal support, leading to division and strife within the society. Toward the wife of his bosom. The wife of his bosom is a poetic way of referring to one's wife, indicating a close and intimate relationship. The verse predicts that even the most intimate and sacred of human relationships, that between husband and wife, will be affected by hostility and animosity. This shift points to a breakdown of the family unit, which is foundational to societal stability and harmony. The remnant of his children, whom he hath remaining, this part of the verse foretells a dire situation where even the children, perhaps those fathers who have survived the curse's hand and are living in the curse, face various calamities like famine, disease, war, drug abuse, lack of knowledge, vices, and abuse. They will not escape the changed demeanor of their oppressed father. The use of remnant suggests that these are the survivors of great hardship, yet instead of cherishing and protecting them, the father will harbor ill will towards them. Dehumanization and racial discrimination. Beginning with the transatlantic slave trade, black people were dehumanized, treated as property, and subjected to brutal conditions. After emancipation, this dehumanization persisted through Jim Crow laws, segregation, and systemic racism that marginalize black Americans in almost every aspect of daily life. Stereotyping and racial profiling. Black men have been and continue to be subjected to negative stereotyping. These stereotypes often paint black men as inherently criminal or dangerous, leading to racial profiling by law enforcement and society at large. Employment discrimination. Despite legal advancements, black men face higher unemployment rates compared to their white counterparts. Discrimination in hiring practices and workplace environments has limited access to economic opportunities and upward mobility. Wealth gap. The legacy of slavery and discriminatory policies like redlining have contributed to a significant wealth gap between black and white families, affecting generations and limiting access to housing, education, and other resources. Mass incarceration. The United States has the highest incarceration rate in the world, disproportionately affecting black men due to systemic biases in the criminal justice system. This has been exacerbated by policies such as the war on drugs, which have targeted black communities. Voting rights. From the Jim Crow era's literacy tests and poll taxes to modern-day voter ID laws and disenfranchisement of felons, black men have faced barriers to their voting rights, impacting their ability to influence political decisions that affect their lives. Mental health. The cumulative effect of systemic racism, discrimination, and socioeconomic disadvantages has significant mental health implications, including higher rates of stress, anxiety, and depression among black men. Physical health disparities. Black men experience disparities in health outcomes, including higher rates of hypertension, heart disease, and diabetes. These disparities are compounded by access issues to quality health care and underlying biases within the healthcare system. Family separation, slavery, involved the forcible separation of families. Modern systemic issues, such as mass incarceration, continue to disrupt black family structures. Educational disparities. Black students face systemic barriers in education, including underfunded schools, lack of resources, and disciplinary practices that disproportionately target black youth. In summary, Deuteronomy 28:54 warns of a complete erosion of social and familial bonds as a consequence of disobedience to God. It illustrates how the curses will lead to a societal collapse where even the most gentle and loving individuals turn against their family and community members. This transformation serves as a stark warning of the potential consequences of turning away from the covenant with God, emphasizing the importance of obedience and faithfulness to maintain societal and familial harmony. The sworn oppressor of the Israelites is a hidden mystery for most, and for some, very difficult to comprehend or believe. We will go in depth on the identity of Edom in a later class, but for now, let it be understood that Edom is the enemy of God. For Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. 2 Esdras 6:9. See that no one is sexually immoral, or is godless like Esau, who for a single meal sold his inheritance rights as the oldest son. As it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated. The oppressor is violent. Black children are not born violent. They are trained to be violent because they experience trauma and grow up with it, leading them to act out in violence. The impact of oppression from childhood to adulthood on the development of a criminal mindset is a complex issue that intertwines with historical and social factors. The experiences of individuals who endured slavery between the 1600 and 1900s and the systemic oppression that followed during the 1800s to 1900s provide a poignant context for understanding how abusive environments can shape behavior and psychological development of the cursed descendants of the Israelites. During the period of slavery, when the cursed Israelite children born into bondage witnessed and experienced unimaginable cruelties, they were often separated from their families, subjected to physical and psychological abuse, and denied any form of education or personal freedom. This dehumanization process not only stripped them of their childhood, but also instilled in them the harsh realities of violence, abuse, and exploitation from a very young age. Modern slavery generates wealth from the bodies of Israelites. The child grows in a broken home. While wealthy Edomites profit from the oppression, the enemy of God is diabolical. The wealth gained from the enslavement of the Israelites has built a world full of resources for a nation, a malicious people born to oppress the Israelites. Just like in the movie The Matrix, the cursed Israelites are living in a real simulation of a prison planet that prevents them from succeeding as a group. Black codes and Jim Crow laws. These laws, enacted in the late 19th and early 20th centuries, were designed to restrict the freedoms of African Americans and ensure their availability as a cheap labor force. They perpetuated an environment of fear and submission. Lynching and racial violence. Acts of violence, including lynching, were used as tools of terror to enforce racial subordination and discourage any form of resistance or aspiration for equality. Economic exploitation, Sharecropping and slavery systems bound many descendants of the Israelites in America to a cycle of debt and poverty, limiting their opportunities for education and advancement. The legacy of these historical oppressions has lasting impacts on communities. The systemic inequalities rooted in these periods have contributed to ongoing disparities in education. In modern slavery generates wealth from the bodies of Israelites. The child grows in a broken home, while wealthy Edomites profit from the oppression. The enemy of God is diabolical. Living a life under a wicked oppressor. The systemic inequalities rooted in these periods have contributed to ongoing disparities in education, employment, housing, and the criminal justice system. Research in psychology and sociology suggests that environments marked by violence, poverty, and lack of opportunity can contribute to the development of antisocial behavior and criminality. The school-to-prison pipeline is a modern manifestation of systemic oppression, where punitive school policies disproportionately affected the scattered Israelites into an oppressed minority and economically disadvantaged students, increasing their likelihood of incarceration. The oppression is designed to perpetuate wealth accumulation at the expense of enslaved individuals. This diabolical scheme, aimed at generating capital, cunningly shifted focus towards exploiting criminal behavior following the Emancipation Proclamation. By transforming systemic injustices into profitable ventures, the cycle of oppression cleverly reinvents itself, ensuring a continuous flow of capital from the very bodies that were once overtly enslaved. Through these mechanisms, the oppression of marginalized communities is meticulously maintained, ensuring their labor and struggles continue to serve as a foundation for wealth generation, thereby illustrating a dark, ongoing chapter in the history of exploitation. The commandment, "You shall not murder," is a cornerstone of biblical law, prohibiting the unjust taking of life. Acts of violence that lead to death are clear violations of this command. Slavery involves the theft of a person's freedom and autonomy, a clear violation of the commandment against stealing. The Bible explicitly condemns kidnapping, which is often a component of slavery, especially in the transatlantic slave trade context. The Bible repeatedly calls for the protection of the weak, the poor, and the stranger, condemning their oppression. This commandment underlines the principle of treating others with the same care and respect one would desire. Violence and enslavement are antithetical to this law. The propagation of ideologies that justified slavery often involved lies and dehumanization of enslaved individuals, violating the commandment against bearing false witness. The Bible is replete with teachings and proverbs that emphasize God's opposition to oppression and violence. These verses span both the Old and New Testaments, offering a consistent message that such actions are contrary to the will and character of God. Here are several biblical sayings and teachings that highlight God's stance against the violence of an oppressor. Proverbs 21:15, "When justice is done, it brings joy to the righteous, but terror to evildoers." This proverb underscores the value God places on justice and the divine opposition to those who engage in evil acts, including oppression and violence. Proverbs 14:31, "Whoever oppresses the poor shows contempt for their maker, but whoever is kind to the needy honors God." This teaches that oppression is not only a crime against the oppressed, but is also seen as an affront to God Himself. Isaiah 1:17, "Learn to do right, seek justice, defend the oppressed, take up the cause of the fatherless, plead the case of the widow. The prophet Isaiah conveys God's directives to his people, emphasizing the importance of justice and the protection of those who are most vulnerable to oppression. Micah 6:8. He has shown you, O mortal, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? To act justly and to love mercy and to walk humbly with your God. This verse encapsulates the ethical and moral behavior expected from the followers of God, including acting against violence and oppression. Psalm 82:3-4. Defend the weak and the fatherless. Uphold the cause of the poor and the oppressed. Rescue the weak and the needy. Deliver them from the hand of the wicked. The Psalms often reflect God's heart for justice and his concern for those suffering under oppression. Proverbs 22:22-23. Do not exploit the poor because they are poor, and do not crush the needy in court, for the Lord will take up their case and will exact life for life. This proverb warns against the exploitation and oppression of the poor, highlighting that God himself will take up their cause. Luke 4:18-19. The Spirit of the Lord is on me, because he has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind, to set the oppressed free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. Here Jesus quotes Isaiah to describe his mission, emphasizing liberation for the oppressed as a core aspect of his ministry. James 2:13. Because judgment without mercy will be shown to anyone who has not been merciful. Mercy triumphs over judgment. The Epistle of James teaches that mercy is a fundamental value in the eyes of God, contrasting sharply with acts of violence and oppression which lack mercy. These verses collectively articulate a clear biblical stance that violence and oppression are abhorrent to God. They call for justice, mercy, and compassion towards all individuals, especially the poor, the oppressed, and the vulnerable. The consistent biblical message is that followers of God are to reflect his character by actively opposing oppression and violence, seeking to bring about justice and healing in their communities and the world. The slave driver or taskmaster wasn't created to make you happy or repair damage with restoration. His purpose is to keep his foot on the Israelites' neck until the time of the Gentiles comes to an end. So don't expect them to save you or stop deceiving you. It's their wicked empires, not yours. And it's a curse to ask the oppressor for reparations. Required reading. The Color of Law, A Forgotten History of and How Our Government Segregated America by Richard Rothstein. Overturning the Culture of Violence by Penny Hess. Medical Apartheid, The Dark History of Medical Experimentation on Black Americans from Colonial Times to the Present by Harriet A. Washington. Madness, Race and Insanity in a Jim Crow Asylum by Antonia Hilton. Stamped from the Beginning, The Definitive History of Racist Ideas in America by Ibram X. Kendi. The New Jim Crow, Mass Incarceration in the Age of Colorblindness by Michelle Alexander. Post-Traumatic Slave Syndrome, America's Legacy of Enduring Injury and Healing by Joya DeGruy. The United Independent Compensatory Code System Concept. Textbook, A Compensatory Counter-Racist Code by Neely Fuller. The Willie Lynch Letter and the Making of a Slave by Willie Lynch. White Fragility, Why It's So Hard for White People to Talk About Racism by Dr. Robin DiAngelo and Michael Eric Dyson. Incidents in the Life of a Slave Girl by Harriet Jacobs. Emancipated from Mental Slavery, Selected Sayings of Marcus Garvey by Namdi Azikiwe, author, Marcus Garvey. And I saw another angel ascending from the east, having the seal of the living God, and he cried with a loud voice to the four angels, to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea, saying, Hurt not the earth, neither the sea nor the trees, till we have sealed the servants of our God in their foreheads.